chairman of the Prime Minister's Economic Advisory Council, an economist of repute in his own right. Mr. Deb Roy, to begin with, you've listened to what Dr. Mitra said. And let's look at the issue that we're debating, which is the West Bengal model or the Bengal model, growth versus populism. He believes, and he's argued, that populism does lead to growth. The populistic measures that his government took actually enabled a lot of development and growth with it. Where do you stand on this?
Well, Raj, thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks to the India Today group. It's always a pleasure. The topic, of course, is industrialization, West Bengal, or its lack, and I hope we come back to that. I'm not very sure which part of Dr. Mitra's statement you want me to react to, because some of it was with a view to his aspirations of if and when he becomes a member of parliament. I don't really think he answered your question. I am a victim at that time and a beneficiary in hindsight of human capital flight from West Bengal, which was the 1970s. In the 1970s, many people here will have forgotten it, there was a refrain in West Bengal, articulated amongst others by the then finance minister of West Bengal, Dr. Ashok Mitra, but others also articulated it. I will state it in Bengali because it sounds better in Bengali. Kendrer bimatri shulabh achoron, the stepmotherly treatment of the center. So every problem is because of the stepmotherly treatment of the center. So that refrain does not seem to have changed at all in the last several years. So that would be my response. So far as health is concerned, because he also made a point about health, anyone who discusses India's policies should be familiar with the 7th schedule of the Constitution, which has a union list, it has a state list, and it has a concurrent list. Health, contrary to popular impressions in several places, is squarely in the state list. That is the reason states are getting resources untied through the Finance Commission. COVID is an exception, but otherwise, why do you think the Finance Commission is giving states money? It is primarily to spend on the social sectors, most of which, some of which, are in the state list. Health entirely a part of education. Why are you looking skeptically at me? You can take out the 7th schedule.
I was listening to you and I was thinking, if you look at the central government schemes, they are close to something over 250, would you say, centrally sponsored as well as central schemes themselves. Isn't this also vote bank politics that is being played out? And, you know, while on one side
Which one is the vote bank politics? The existence of centrally sponsored schemes or the attempt to prune them? Which one?
Well,
wait a minute.
Sure.
Because there is a difference between central sector schemes and centrally sponsored schemes. Central sector schemes are 100% funded by the union government.
Like the Kisan.
We should not use the word center. In fact, someone like Dr. Mitra, who's so very conscious of federalism, should never use the word center and center-state relations. The word center does not exist in the Constitution. The word center suggests that there is something sitting at the center and everything else is a periphery. The word used in the Constitution is union. So let us stick to the word union. However, they happen to be called central sector schemes, 100% funded by the union government, and centrally sponsored schemes, which are require a matching contribution by state governments. When did the increase in the number of centrally sponsored schemes happen? In the 1960s, second half of the 1960s, under Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. So that is a word to reflect on.
But Prime Minister Modi has, Prime Minister Modi himself has introduced a whole range of...
Just one second.
Union schemes, if you'd like to talk about.
Not a whole, in terms of numbers, not a whole list. Until recently, there were 455 centrally sponsored schemes. Not central schemes, centrally sponsored schemes. Progressively, they have been pruned. And today, not major schemes, all schemes together, there are about 170. Under the GST system, we have a forum for discussing union state taxation issues, at least so far as indirect taxes are concerned. Equivalently, we need a forum to discuss expenditure consensus between the union government and the states. In fact, the states themselves have been saying, ever since 1967, the meeting of the National Development Council pruned centrally sponsored schemes. What is the status today? We have the Finance Commission. The Finance Commission has made some recommendations on centrally sponsored schemes, the 15th Finance Commission. The Finance Minister has announced in a budget speech that in the course of the year, they will be examined and pruned. That, to me, is federalism, because this is based on the recommendations of the 15th Finance Commission, not at the whims and the fancies of the maligned union government.
Okay, I'm going to come back to the question of growth versus populism. I'm putting across a proposition to you. If you were in Dr. Amit Mitra's place, you said he has ambitions of becoming a member of parliament. You might.
I did not say that. I said I would deduce that.
Yeah. You might, may have ambitions to become West Bengal's finance minister. Even if you didn't, what would your advice be what would you do for West Bengal?
I have no such desires. Let me state it very categorically. The first thing I would do is stop pointing a finger at others and try and ask the question of, is there something wrong with me? Focus a little less on, what is the expression he used? The propaganda and the myth, he probably equated the two. And look at, what are the problems? Why is it the case? This is not, if I am going to do what is good for the state of West Bengal, I should be less fixated on what I have done in the last 5 years and ask myself the question, that in the 60s, if one is going to correlate with someone, Dr. Bidhan Chandra Ray, until the time of Dr. Bidhan Chandra Ray as the Chief Minister of West Bengal, whether it is in per capita GSDP terms, whether it is in industrial growth terms, West Bengal was amongst the top. Today, whether it is per capita GSDP, whether it is the rate of industrial growth, and there is a difference between industry and manufacture, which I hope we come back to, West Bengal is just about average.
And why did this happen?
Today, the question to ask, I'll answer that in a minute. Today, the question to ask, is West Bengal content with being just about average or marginally better? Or should West Bengal be talked about in the same breath as Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Gujarat, and Maharashtra? That is really the question to ask. In terms of what is responsible for all of this, a large number of studies have been done, empirical studies, respectable academic studies, long list of about what hinders, and now I'm particularly talking about manufacturing. Because there is agriculture, there is services, and within industry there is a non-manufacturing
component. And we have an eminent industrialist here, Mr. Niyotia, he's listening to you.
No, he will disagree. He's very nice and polite. He will disagree with me in private, not in public. So if you look at all of these studies, and you look at the list, you find number one is law and order. uniformly across all of these. Number one is law and order. Number two, invariably, is labor. Now, when I say labor, one is not simply talking about labor laws. One is talking about labor militancy. One is talking about work ethics. One is talking about skills. One is talking about productivity. And Mr. Neutia will well remember what happened. I forget the year. Was it 1967 when a noted industrialist was virtually stripped and dragged in a certain part of the... That sends a signal. So there is labor. And then there is land. Because classic manufacturing, unlike services and IT, requires land. Below that, you have infrastructure. You have roads, particularly power rates. And much below that, at the margin, you have fiscal incentives. And fiscal incentives, A, make a difference only at the margin, and B, because of the taxation reforms, fiscal incentives are on the way out. So if one is going to ask a question about what needs to be done for revival, one would ask law and order, labor, not purely the labor laws, the work in ethics, skills, etc., roads, power rates, and land.
Well, if you listen to Dr. Mitra, he did seem to indicate that there was an impressive growth in industry during the TMC period. But there's also a point that I'd like you to answer. The fact is that if new industry is not coming into West Bengal, or West Bengal industry is not going, let us not forget also that the economy has slowed down under the Modi government even before COVID happened. Under your watch in some senses, let's put it that way. Therefore, you're getting more, less greenfield investments, more brownfield expansion that is happening. Industrialists are holding back elsewhere. Why blame Bengal?
No one is blaming Bengal. But in the midst of this, forget COVID and the lockdown, in the midst of the slowdown, after all, this is a relative question. In the midst of the slowdown, there are states that have done relatively better than West Bengal. It's a relative question. There's a quote attributed to Lord Keynes. There's no evidence he ever said that, but it's a quote attributed to Keynes, because anything you cannot attribute to an economist is invariably attributed to Lord Keynes, just as something you do not know who said it but sounds clever is attributed in the area of literature to Oscar Wilde. So Lord Keynes was apparently once asked, how is your wife? And he said, compared to whose wife? So if we are looking at West Bengal, we have to ask the question in the perspective of Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Karnataka. These are all different, by the way, because the composition is a little bit different. Gujarat is the real manufacturing one. Tamil Nadu, Karnataka have a little bit of that. But so that is the question to ask. Now, so far as manufacturing is concerned, it is not that there is no manufacturing in West Bengal. Many people here will be surprised to know that the number of people employed in manufacturing in West Bengal, the data are a little bit dated, doesn't matter. The number of people employed in manufacturing in West Bengal is three times the number in Gujarat. Thrice. The problem is the nature of manufacturing. The manufacturing here is micro. Cottage. The question to ask is manufacturing, just as manufacturing does not happen in India, manufacturing happens in different states. Exactly similarly, here we are sitting here discussing the industrial manufacturing future of West Bengal, but we need to ask ourselves, what is West Bengal? I think there are 23 districts now. There are 23 districts. In which of these 23 districts is manufacturing likely to occur? I'm not talking about agro-based diversification. I'm not talking about aquaculture and forestry and this, that, and the other. And the answer you will come up to with manufacturing is essentially North 24 Parganas, South 24 Parganas, maybe Howrah and Hooghly. Not even Kolkata. Kolkata is not manufacturing. And what we need to ask is, what were the traditional industries here? The likes of shipbuilding, chemicals, jute, how many of them will survive now? With technological changes, much of modern manufacturing is capital intensive. So I need to do an identification, whoever is the finance minister, picking out the comparative advantage in manufacturing of each of these districts. The last time an inter-district analysis was done for West Bengal, unless I am wrong, was in the year 2004. 16 years have passed. Why do we not have a comparative perspective? 16 years ago, it was the Human Development Report. After that, why don't we have something comparable for the districts? What is the point of shouting from the rooftops about manufacturing growth in West Bengal? That's not going to happen. It's going to happen in Howrah. What? Engineering goods? What kind of industry?
But can I stop you for a moment? If you look at the center itself, which you oversee, what has been the growth in manufacturing? The Modi government had promised to go up to 20%, 25% at one time. It's still stagnant at around 14 to 16%. You haven't answered the question on two things. Yeah, let's finish with manufacturing.
No. You're mixing up.
And therefore, we're looking at... Yeah, go ahead.
You're mixing up two different metrics.
Sure.
One metric is the growth rate in manufacturing, which is an absolute. The other metric is the share of manufacturing in GDP or GSDP, as the case may be. A share, like Lord Keynes, is relative. It is a function of how services are doing. It's a function of how agriculture is doing.
No, so would you say manufacturing India, that is, right across, not just West Bengal, has kept pace, has really, this thing, everyone talks of it being stagnant, it really hasn't improved.
No, like I said, West...
Under Modi government, I'm talking about.
Under Modi government, under the government preceding it, since the mid-60s, West Bengal has been average. Now, you may be comfortable with the average. Average is for all India. The figure you're talking about is all India. But look, if one is talking about GDP for India, except defense and railways and to some extent national highways and airports, the rest of it is generated in the states. Averages reveal certain things, they also hide certain things. If you catch hold of me, put one of my feet inside a fridge and the other one inside an oven, on an average, I will be comfortable.
No, but let's
take question GDP. Question is West Bengal pulling up the country's average? Is it pulling down the country's average? Or is it maintaining the average at what it is? It is not pulling it down, but it is not pulling it up either.
But look at India's GDP under your watch. It is average. Whose wife would you like to compare with on this?
Sorry?
Why is it slowed down so much? This was a government that promised, mocked the previous government for low growth, and now is stuck in a low growth path, and it is not going to match at the end.
Okay, I have no problem with answering the question, but let us recognize that now we have switched the topic from what is wrong with industry in West Bengal to blaming the Modi government.
Modi government's performance is average, let us see the performance of the central government when it came to any of these things. And therefore, we are comparing wives in some senses.
But I already responded saying West Bengal is around the average. Now, so far
is Modi government around average, would you say?
I just told you that the Modi government, 95% of national income happens at the level of the states. It does not happen, manufacturing does not happen in 7 Lok Kalyan Marg. Had it happened, the performance would have been far better.
So the states are to blame on this, you're saying?
I'm not saying the states have to be blamed. Factually, it happens in the states. There are various reasons why it has not happened. You asked two questions. One was about GDP. GDP, there are essentially 4 sources of growth. There is consumption, there is private investment, there is government expenditure, and there is the external sector. World over, everyone knows that much before COVID, the external sector had begun to slow down. And the high growth years that India witnessed of 9% GDP growth, they were all years in which India's exports in dollar terms grew by 15% and more. If you do a simple calculation of the share of exports in GDP, you will find that 3% to 3.5% is whittled away because the export effect has gone. So automatically from 9%, you drop to about 6%. Now, so far as manufacturing is concerned, regardless of the state, there are issues of forest clearances, there are issues of clearances generally, the issues of environmental clearances, and there are issues connected with land, power, water, etc., etc., some of which is sought to be addressed in something that Dr. Mitra mentioned, the DIPP's ease of doing business, but not all of it.
Now, if you come to another thing, we're coming back to populism and the kind of schemes we had talked of earlier. One of the things that seems to be a problem is implementation of these schemes, not just at the West Bengal level, but also at the central level. Though the track record on some of the schemes that the Modi government has done has been particularly good. The issue is, which is that independent body that is monitoring these schemes? I'm told earlier in the Planning Commission there was such a body, but since Niti Aayog, and you were a member of Niti Aayog, has come, that body is gone, and therefore we as public don't have, even as press, we are not able to assess how successful these schemes are.
You see, look, Raj, let me... This links up with a question that you had asked earlier. Everyone has an annual budget. The India Today Group has an annual budget. Harsh has an annual budget. When you do an annual budget, you have to do a prioritization. And therefore, as a polity, not as a union government, as a polity, union and state governments, we must decide what are the priorities for public expenditure. If we have 165 plus schemes or 200 plus schemes, I will never be able to monitor them effectively. We need to have that prioritization that these are the 10 most schemes that we will implement, which means I cut down on the centrally planned schemes. It cannot be. And this prioritization is for states as well as the center. Because if I think as a state that giving bicycles free is important, let me generate my resources through other means or using the resources that the Finance Commission has given me. That's the reason Finance Commission...
No, but my question still remains. How do you go about assessing this? Because you either have the sample surveys, which is again a sample, and people say, which sample did you choose? Or if you look at, as I said, an independent body, why aren't you all advocating for that? That you have a body that reviews the progress, stop the fudging of figures? We're not certain. I mean, if I go down and see a few things, you'll say, well, you're biased. You went to this district, but you go to that, they're doing properly.
No, look. A mechanical kind of examination is very easy. Is the money being spent on the purpose for which it is being spent? To some extent, the arm of Niti Aayog still does it. In some fashion, the CAG also does it. But obviously, whether it is the CAG or some wing of Niti Aayog, you cannot do it for all of those schemes. But you must remember a fundamental issue. Many of these public expenditure schemes, I'm not talking about national highways, and a lot of the central schemes now have geotagging, including in the social sectors. But if I'm going to argue, is this social sector intervention leading to an improvement in social sector outcomes? That's much more difficult to do because the causal relationships are much, much more complicated.
And it will take a decade to also assess if you have to look at education. And if you see growth in literacy, growth in,
function of all kinds of complicated things. If I look at the reasons why the infant mortality rate has dropped in Kerala and compare them to the reasons why the infant mortality rate has dropped in Tamil Nadu, the reasons are completely different.
Well, we've got about 3 minutes or 4 minutes left, Vivekji. And I want to focus on what you said, an industrial policy for West Bengal. What are its competitive advantages? Is West Bengal leveraging it? And what would you do in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 if West Bengal has to grow industrially?
Firstly, I will...
Faster. I'm saying grow faster.
Firstly, I will say that I have to figure out, do I want manufacturing? Why am I saying this? Traditionally, Howrah had a lot of manufacturing. But there is environmental consciousness. So something like leather or something that's not environmentally friendly, and Howrah now has a municipality, it's being pushed out. So A, I have to ask, do I want manufacturing? What kind of manufacturing, knowing that modern manufacturing is not going to be labor intensive? Where, in which districts? What am I going to produce? Is it light engineering? Am I going to do something that's linked to Haldia in Purva Medinipur? Am I going to do something in Bardhaman, both districts? Next, what is the stock of land I have? I cannot expect the private sector to go out and acquire land, too complicated. Do I have state government acquired land? And I'm talking about manufacturing. I'm not talking about ITA and ITES. Next, I will have to ask about education and skills. I will have to ask the question, why is it the case that train loads of students from West Bengal go to study elsewhere? I will have to ask the question that why is education, which is a determinant of skills, which is a determinant of IT also, so heavily, heavily controlled in West Bengal across governments since for a very, very long time. Why is the case that there has been a steady deterioration in standards of education, particularly higher education in West Bengal? I will have to improve law and order. You mentioned, you didn't use a word for it, you mentioned the 10% tax. The 10% tax
is... Syndicate Raj, are you talking about?
The 10% tax is never... The 10% tax is never an issue. Don't get me wrong, I'm not being moralistic about it. The 10% tax is not an issue, provided I know who to pay it to, and provided the work gets done after that 10% is paid. There are problematic states where I don't know where that 10% is to be paid, who that 10% is to be paid to, and the work does not get done even after that 10% is paid. So I also need to talk about law and order in the sense of administration. There must be an administration which delivers governance, an administration that is dealing from the party apparatus. And finally, look inside, not continuously blame Raj Changappa for all the problems.
No, you. But I'm coming. You got exactly what, 45 seconds. Now, you are advising the Prime Minister. And if you had to advise him what to give West Bengal in terms of incentives for manufacturing or any other thing, what would you do? And have you told him that?
So far as the Prime Minister is concerned, whatever advice I give him remains for his ears, not for public disclosure. So far as the West Bengal citizens are concerned, I guess the only advice I have is vote wisely.
Hold?
Vote wisely.
Now you're playing politics. It looks like you're getting to this.
No, did I say vote for the BJP? I did not. I said vote wisely.
But you're still not coming up with one thing that the center can do for West Bengal right now. If it wanted to.
Union government, manufacturing will happen in West Bengal, not because of what the union government does.
So you don't have anything on your plate?
Plate, platter, one will have to wait.
Okay. With that, thank you very much, Mr. Bibek Debroy, for this. Please give him a warm round of applause. Thank you.